Hey guys, what's up? It's Zyphlin here. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys bolt builds. I've got four of them to show you guys. Bolt is a very versatile frame, and you can do a lot with him. He gets a lot of flack for being underwhelming, but I can't help but disagree because he is really useful, especially as a starter frame. You know, you can just sort of pick him up and do whatever with him. Like, he's AoE DPS, you can use him for Eidolons, you can use him for speedrunning, you can use him for crowd control, you can use him to buff up your damage. You know, he's a really, really good frame. So, let's take a look at the four builds I put together for our boy over here. Now, of course, these builds incorporate a Umbral Forma, and that's because I want my builds to be really flexible but really good at the same time. Umbral Forma just allows me to put on an Umbral mod and then half the cost of it instead of having the Forma every single other slot, and then base my builds around, you know, the polarities that I've already got on, you know, if that makes any sense. So yeah, this is our speed build. This is probably the one that everybody is going to be looking for. It is basically like, if you want a whack ton of strength, a whack ton of duration, and call it a day. So Umbral Intensify, Transient Fortitude, Blind Rage for our Pyre Strength, as well as Augur Secrets on here too. We've got Speed Drift and Rush. The reason that we have these two mods on is because Volt's speed build is going to benefit more from having a higher sprint speed compared to having a ton of Pyre Strength. Of course, having both on is great, but the base sprint speed actually matters more because speed is kind of like a multiplier, right? So the multiplier can only go up so far. It's capped out by the Pyre Strength. And then, of course, having a higher base value means it's going to be just a higher number whenever it comes out the other end of the equation, right? So on top of that, we just throw on Duration and call it a day, right? Constitution, Gnar Minded, Prime Continuity. That's pretty much that. And then, of course, Sprint Boost in the aura because, again, increasing that base sprint speed. Arcane Consequences on there because it increases your parkour velocity, which just makes you parkour faster. And then Arcane Energize, because we have Blind Rage on here, you're going to run over an energy orb and you're going to get a ton of energy back. Of course, you want to be running Energizing Dash on there to get your energy in the first place, but you should be able to cast speed reliably anyway. It costs 38.75 energy, so it's a lot, but it lasts for 25 seconds and you got a 2.6 multi on the speed boost, so that's great. So that's basically that. Eidolon shield build. So this is whenever you're going to be spamming your shield to shoot through it whenever you're doing the damage phase of the Eidolon fights. It is natural talent for a shit ton of cast speed, right? So you can get them out super fast. You've got on speed drift as well on top of that to, you know, speed up your casting speed even more. Prime Continuity, Constitution, Gnar Minded to make your shields last longer. Gnar Minded is negative range on it as well. It doesn't actually affect the shields, which is great. Then we have Fleet Expertise and Streamline, so we can just spam it. Umbral Vitality for health because we need to stay alive. And Coaction Drift to make it so we take away more armor from the Eidolon. Therefore, we deal more damage with our Lenka or Rubikal Shot, which is, you know, pretty self-explanatory. So this is a really good build just for spamming your shield and taking part in an Eidolon fight. Moving on to the Eidolon DPS build, this one's a little bit different. You are the damage dealer, and you're going to be using the Shock Tripper Augment to cast, more electric damage on yourself and your friends, right? So you hold it, and you just get more electric damage. This is especially good if you're using the Lenka and you're building for radiation, which is what you should be doing versus the Eidolons, right? And then the rest of that is, Blame Rage is on here for Pyre Strength. We've got on Fleet Expertise for efficiency, so we can actually get the cast off. Gnar Minded, so the cast lasts a long time. Adaptation, Umbral Vitality for survivability. Vigorous Swap, now this is a really interesting one. We just basically swap between our weapons. It gives us more holster speed, so we swap faster and you get a bonus damage from that as well, which is really, really, really good. And Enemy Radar, and this is for attracting the little Vomulus, right? So they're going to be floating around, and if they show up on the radar, they're more likely to come towards you, and you need those for charging your lures, right? So them appearing on the radar just makes them more likely to fly over to you, means that you're going to, you know, get them charged up faster and get the Eidolon done faster. Handspring for just recovery if you get knocked over. Arcane Momentum, This is going to make you reload your sniper faster than Arcane Guardian, because you need that extra armor just to stay alive. So that's pretty much that. Then, in my opinion, the more interesting build, the Steel Path Vault build. Now, this here one is really nice. Actually, hold on. Nah, I'm not going to be able to fit it on. If I hadn't have formed this exoslot right here, there may have been the possibility of fitting on the Prime Sure Fit It mod over Handspring. Handspring is good enough, don't get me wrong, but Prime Sure Fit It is just better because you're completely immune to knockdowns then. You'd have to swap a few mods around on your build or form this exoslot to incorporate a depolarity, but it's entirely down to you. But this is a really, really, really fun build for just like killing a ton of enemies with Vaults 4 and getting a lot of shields. It's kind of similar to the Mag build I showed. You cast your 4, you get a ton of over shields, meaning you basically can't die. But because Vaults 4 acts as like CC and damage, it's just that little bit better. And then of course you have your speed ability, which is going to speed up your attack speed and whatnot, just making it a lot more fun. Umbral Intensify on here for fire strength, paired with Blind Rage. Prime Continuity for duration, overextended for range, streamline for ability efficiency. You could swap this out for Fleet and Expertise if you really wanted to, but then you're whacking a little bit of duration off your speed and whatnot, so eh. Stretch is paired with overextended for range, Ruling Guard so we can stay alive, Handspring for recovery, Burst Projection just because, you know, reducing armor is good. Or you can swap this out for whatever you want, because I've got an Aura Forma on here, so that's basically that. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to jump into a Steel Path Survival, and we're going to just run around for like 5 minutes or so just to show off the build, you know. So I'm going to use the Core of Prime this time. Let's go back to the Cuban Yukor. Cuban Yukor is just a really good weapon for applying status effects to enemies, you know. So it's really good whenever you pair it with a melee weapon that has conditioned overload, right? So that's pretty much that. And then this Moa, I gotta take this here off and go for my Kavat, because Kavat meta. I am so close to getting MR30. That's kind of like my next goal in Warframe. I say I'm really close, I'm actually like really far away. There's a lot of like really annoying things that I have to do. But whenever I do eventually get MR30, I'm gonna get another free Umbra Forma, meaning I can make more like really sick builds for my frames and show them off to you guys. So, you know. But yeah, here we go. Energizing dash. And we go fast. Energizing dash, we go fast. Anyone else? Pretty good. Oh, I have Mac Rush on my operator. I wonder what I've swapped off for that. But here we go. We use our 4. Tons of overshields. Tons of CC. And you basically want to be using your 4 as much as possible to keep all the enemies stunned. And then if you do happen to get hit, well, you of course have your Ruling Guard and your shield gating to protect you from dying. But you should be able to survive with this build pretty easily. Now, I've got Thermal Sunder in my first ability. You could subsume a more worthwhile ability into the first slot if you really wanted to in place of the Steel Path config. I just had Thermal Sunder on there for leveling, you know. So Thermal Sunder is a really good ability for just jumping in the Sanctuary Onslaught, spamming your 1, which would be Thermal Sunder in this case, and then leveling up really quickly. But as you can see, the enemies basically cannot touch me, and if I do feel like I'm gonna get shot, I can go ahead, go into my Ruling Guard, and then cast my 4 safely, because I'm totally immune, or I can rely on my shield getting, because we have a ton of shields, right? So I've got 1.3k at the minute, so my 4 is down, cast my 4, pretty hefty range on it, and it chains from one enemy to the other, so it's pretty sweet. So everybody's like, yeah, Vault is bad, wouldn't use him in high level missions. And I mean, like, he's not the most interesting frame to play in high level missions, don't get me wrong, because it is just cast 4, all enemy stuns, and then maybe have your 2 up to increase your DPS with your melee or whatever, but you can do some interesting things, you know. Like, he's not a one-trick pony like everybody says he is. He's got a lot going for him, and there's different things that you can do with him. Those 4 builds that I showed you, those are just the builds that I recommend sort of like shooting for in terms of Vault. Like, if you want to be somebody who means Vault, those would be the 4 builds I'd recommend picking up and and going for it, because that's just gonna let you do the content that you need to do as a Bolt main. You know what I'm saying? So our speed ability has a 15 second duration, which is better than nothing, honestly. I would like it to be a little bit higher. Like, I would like it to go to 25 like we have it on the actual speed build, but it is what it is, you know? It is what it is. Climb on down. Just some enemies. We're basically just going to be doing this for the 5 minutes. Hoping I don't get shot. Realistically, what's going to kill me is probably the Acolyte. The Acolyte or Vore. Because the Acolyte can, like, TP you and knock you over. It's kind of bullshit. That's what you really have to watch out for with, whenever you're playing Steel Path, you know? Getting knocked down. Because whenever you get knocked down or CC'd or something, that's whenever you're screwed, right? That's whenever you're vulnerable, you're in the open, you can't use an ability, you can't do your rolling guard, stuff like that. There's also another mod called Brief Respite, right? I forget. But you can put that in the aura, I'm pretty sure. And that's supposedly really good for keeping you alive. I don't have it personally. I should probably go pick it up, but I think that the defensive capabilities that I have on this build, implying I'm playing the game right, are definitely good enough, because taking off Caruso Projection, like, that's a massive hit to your damage, especially whenever you're playing a frame like Bolt, who doesn't have a way of stripping away enemy armor. On the mag build I showed you guys yesterday, you know, you can definitely get away with swapping up the aura slot, because, well, you have methods of stripping the armor. And then the Ash build as well, like, because Ash deals finisher damage or true damage or whatever you want to call it, like, you just kill people anyway. On top of that, you can pair Ash's Bleedstorm with Savage Silence Banshee, you know, her augment, which increases finisher damage by 300%. You pair it with that and you basically one-shot everything with Bleedstorm, regardless of their armor value and their health value. So Ash is pretty nutty, Mag is pretty nutty. The Atlas one I did, I don't know, Atlas wouldn't be a frame that I would recommend using in Steel Path anyway. You can definitely do it, and he does deal a decent amount of damage with his Landslide, but if you're doing like a super serious run, like you're trying to survive for a really long time, and I'm talking like over an hour, then I'd recommend other frames. You can definitely do it with Vault. Here comes the Acolyte and Vore, so now I start to panic. Gotta kill this Squidward, get knocked over. But Handspring saved us. Feels good, man. Clap in the chat. You know what I'm saying? Gotta kill Vore. Gotta kill this Acolyte. I wish Vore's health bar also appeared at the top of the screen as well. That'd be very, very nice. Already done the 5 minutes. No, don't TP me. I need to use my 4. I'm gonna die. Ah! Where is this guy? No! Stop knocking me over, bro! No. I used my 4. So you see how many times, like, I've been shot? Like, I should have been one-shot it, but because we have shield gating and because we have rolling guard, we're still alive, you know? Surviving is a PogChamp, man. Good chat speak. Everybody who doesn't, like, go to Twitch is probably, like, wondering what the heck is this guy talking about, and now I'm dead. I mean, the Acolyte killed me. He just murdered me, but You got the gist of the build. I'm gonna leave now in embarrassment. I'm not like necessarily trying to do a long run. I'm just trying to demonstrate how the builds are played, you know. The developers last year said that they don't like it whenever YouTubers just jump into the simulacrum to show builds off, and they introduced Steel Path so we would use it to show off builds and stuff. So I figured, like, I've got the opportunity to show off these builds, might as well do that, you know what I mean? So yeah, hope you guys have been enjoying the music in the background as well. Hopefully I don't get like copyright striked or something by these music labels. Like, using music in videos is such a risky thing, man. Like, I've been trying my best to get like non-copyright signs and stuff like that, so if the video randomly disappears after watching it, it's because like a music company was like, yo, take the video down or reclaim all the revenue or whatever. So yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. If you liked it, go ahead, hit that like button below. If you want to see more Warframe guides, hit subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.